I'm saying the Hollywood way because they have the power and the reach and the distribution. You know, there was a film a couple of years ago that I saw in Paris. It's called, it starred Gerard Depardieu. I think 3 years ago. Gerard Depardieu, and it was a very good film. That film never made its way to anywhere in Europe or even to India. About 6 months later, the film got remade in Hollywood with De Niro playing the same role. And that film was a hit. It became an American film, when actually the original was France. Second, importantly, I feel that our genre is the song and dance. It is music. It is love stories. And that actually, if you look at the what rules, like it's just 5%. What rules is action, drama, adventure, which is the most popular global genre. So if we can have a genre in the English language, which has a global reach, then we'll be able to start taking those strides. But if we focus only on personal films, musicals, then it's going to be difficult. It will be taken as a novelty, but we will not be able to make that.
I was running a 200 member group for the Walt Disney Company. Everybody was Japanese except for me, and the language of the whole office was Japanese. And one day, a whole bunch of excited people came to me and said, "Sanjiba-san," that's what they used to call me, "Sanjiba-san," or "Rama-san." So "Rama-san, there is a wonderful Indian film that has, is playing Julia. And it's the first Indian film to be released in Tokyo in our lifetimes, and we've never seen an Indian film before, so 20 of us are going and we have to come with this, because we'd like you to explain what's going on." I said, "Yeah, sure." I said, "What's the film called?" And they said, "The Dancing Maharaja." So 20 of us went to the theater and we sat down and the credits rolled. The film was Muthu. It starred Rajinikanth. And it had Japanese subtitles. And I was the only person in the hall who didn't understand the word what went
on. On one side, I understand what you're saying, commercial power, commercial impact. And then it makes sense. But also, what I'm thinking more is like, how can you define like a film, an Iranian film called The Separation? Of course, it got a Golden Bird, you know, but many films got a Golden Bird, they don't work commercially. This film is typically Iranian. It's about a divorce in Iran. It's a bit more about than that, but how can you attract 1 million spectators in France with a subtitle print without being dubbed? How can we even word by mouth say to a neighbor, "Go and see that film, it's an Iranian film about a divorce"? And even if you're a king of marketing, I really am amazed if you can succeed with that. The film itself, it's a word by mouth because the people love it. It talks to the people. And there is no marketing behind. The film was like distributed by a small distributor. And 1 million admission in France, film dub, is a huge success. It's amazing.
I mean, everybody who wants to make a movie wants as many people to watch it as possible, of course. And there are many times when you, like Ashu said, like song and dance, and that's our export, fair enough. That's part of our idiom, that's what we've grown up seeing. We also have folklore, and we have mythology and stuff. But there are, that is not the only kind of storytelling that can come out of India. Or that's not the only kind of writing that's happening. That's not the only kind of films that people want to make. Why are we forced to do this? Because that's what we've done. You know what I mean? But we are song and dance. We may be. But I don't want songs in my film. I don't want dance in my film. That's what I'm saying. There's a lot of work coming. I mean, there are writers that are incredible. Their stories are constantly being cut to fit an audience. And I mean, you spoke of Separation. I mean, I can understand Separation really well in France. When you watch it, I mean, I just saw Amora, Michael Haneke film. And it speaks the same language. You totally understand it. If I gave you an Indian film on a divorce, it's totally alien.
No, I think, see, there are two kinds of filmmakers right now in the country. One is filmmakers who have stories to tell which are for an Indian audience. There is another category of filmmakers who want to tell stories which are, they don't want to have song and dance in it. They don't want to make 2.5 hour films. They want to make 90-minute to 100-minute to 120-minute films. The target audience that they're looking for, international. Because they know that these stories are not going to appeal to an Indian audience. So those filmmakers should be allowed to make their films for a global audience. When I'm saying global, I mean, the stories might find appeal in France, some might find appeal in Germany, some might work very well in the US, wherever it may be, but they should get a chance to tell those stories. Crossover is something that you cannot plan. A film if it appeals to an audience outside what it appeals to India, you can call it as crossover.